So my name is Brad Jones. I'm an assistant professor at the George Washington University, where I've been for just over a year, so fairly new. Before that, I was at the Reagan Institute at Harvard and MIT. And my work focuses on figuring out how we can harness part of the immune system called cytotoxic T cells to try to eliminate HIV reservoirs. So what we're really focusing on is, can we get closer to curing people and so that lifelong antiretroviral therapy is not needed anymore? I think that in general, people might be shifting a bit from talking about sterilizing cures to talking about these functional cures, or maybe the virus isn't completely eliminated, but the immune system can control it. I think in reality, it'll be really hard to know whether we've actually achieved a functional cure or a sterilizing cure, because if the virus doesn't come back, then how do you know it's completely gone? But I think the shift has been driven really by making sure that we're setting realistic expectations that we can meet in a timely fashion. And I think that this idea of remission, where people can stop therapy for certain amounts of time, is something that's going to be more achievable in the short term. And what I would also pitch myself, which is maybe something that hasn't completely caught on in the field, but something that I've been thinking about a lot more lately, is maybe getting people off of therapy should not be the only goal essentially of cure research, because I think that if we can reduce the viral reservoirs, even if we can't stop therapy, maybe that's going to reduce some of the comorbidities that continue to persist. So some of these cardiovascular disease and neurocognitive disorders, maybe that's another way of thinking about it, improving health, improving quality of life further through new biomedical tools, even if people need to continue with therapy for now. So that's another angle. But I think none of these things should be really thought of as silos. I think people working towards a functional cure are going to find things that can assist in a sterilizing cure down the road. And as long as the lines of communication are open and people are talking to each other, there's going to be exchanges both within the cure research. And I think this is also going to inform vaccine development and vice versa. So it's nice to have this diverse set of aims. The short answer is that those avenues of exploration are just not being explored. And the FDA right now, to my understanding, I should preface it by saying I haven't set up a clinical trial, but from what I hear, when they are weighing the risk benefit ratio, basically, to see if a trial can move forward, they consider someone living with HIV who's suppressed on therapy to be a completely healthy individual. So the tolerance for risk is very, very low. So there are a lot of potential therapies that might have some relatively minor risk associated with them, which also can't move forwards. And maybe that's exactly the right approach. Maybe that's correct. But if the community feels that different aspects of living with HIV are not being weighed fully in those balance sheets that they're putting together, then I think there's a space also for advocacy, which of course the community living with HIV has a tremendous history of, in communicating with these regulatory agencies and kind of helping to steer that risk benefit ratio. But I think, yeah, the short answer is that anything that would be considered to have really severe side effects is just over before it starts. An interesting lesson for me that came from one of these OHTN meetings was we were presenting a kind of military analogy for killing the virus. We were going to, I don't even remember what it was exactly, but you know, the immune system lends itself to military analogies because you have T cells and foot soldiers and everything like this. And the point that was made, and I think it's a point many people are aware of, is anytime you engender fear against the virus, you engender to some extent fear against people living with the virus. So I think in the same vein, if you say that we need to cure people so that people aren't stigmatized anymore, then maybe that seems to validate the stigma in a way that it shouldn't. So I'm way outside of my area of expertise here. But also I think just a concrete evidence of how attending these conferences with community members and stuff does shape in some ways the way that we think. So we listen when people make comments like that, or at least I hope most of us